Welcome back in our online English class. In our previous video, we have seen that the Kabuliwala returns from jail and he comes to Mini's house. He enters in Mini's house and then he talks with Mini's father. Now Mini's father feels insecure because the Kabuliwala was coming from jail and it was the day of Mini's marriage. So he was feeling a little insecure and then he said that I have worked, there is ceremony at house. And I cannot talk now, come other day. So Kabuliwala was returning again, he comes back. And he asked that, where is the little one? I have brought some things to her. Because the Kabuliwala was thinking that Mini is still the small girl. So then, again her father says that Mini wouldn't be able to meet because there is a work, there is ceremony in the house and nobody is free. So Kabuliwala becomes sad and he was returning. Again he comes back and then he gives that whatever raisins and all he brought, nuts, to Mini's father. Today we'll see next. I took them and was going to pay him, but he caught my hand and said, "Kind sir, don't offer me any money. I do have a daughter like her in my home. I think of her and bring fruits for your child, not to make any profit." See, as now he gave the nuts and fruits to Mini's father and said, "Give them to Mini." Mini's father was going to pay him some money. So he held Mini's father's hand and said that, "Kind sir, please don't offer me any money. I don't do this for any money. I have a daughter like your daughter at my house and I think of her and I bring fruits and nuts to your child. So please don't offer me money. I don't do this for any profit." Saying this, he took out from his pocket a small piece of paper. With great care, he smoothed it out on my table. It bore the impression of a little hand. The impression of an ink smeared hand lay flat on the paper. Now see here, saying what he did, saying all these things what he did, he took out a small piece of paper from his pocket and he put it on the paper with very great care. Very great care, he smoothed it on the table. Who? The Kabuliwala. And what was there on the paper? There was the impression of little hand. There was the impression of little hand on the paper, which was of inks. It was ink smear. Ink smear means when you put hand in the ink and then on the paper. So it was ink smear, hand laid on the flat paper. You can see here. So there was an impression of hand. Tears came to my eyes. I sent for Mini immediately. Many objections were raised, but I would not listen. Mini came and stood bashfully before me. She was clad in the red silk of her wedding veil. Now see, whose hand's impression was this? This was the impression of Mini's hand. This was the impression of Mini's hand, and the Kabuliwala had kept it very carefully these many years. So carefully he took out from pocket and he laid it on the table. Now when Mini's father saw this, tears came out of his eyes and he sent immediately someone to call Mini. He sent someone to call Mini immediately. Now many objections were raised that why Mini is called in the house, because it is her marriage day and why she is called in the house. But Mini's father did not listen anyone. He did not listen anyone, he did not listen anything. Mini came and stood in front of him bashfully. That means like a shy person with the head down. And then in that day she wore what? Silk dress of her wedding. She was in the red silk dress. Mini was in the red silk dress of her wedding day. Now see, the The Kabulwala looked deeply astonished. At last he smiled and said, "Return word, are you going to your father-in-law's house?" Now this Kabulwala was astonished to see that Minnie had grown so much big, and it was her marriage today. It was a surprise for the Kabulwala that Minnie had grown a big girl and it is her marriage day today. So she said that, he smiled and he said to her that, "Little one, are you going to your father-in-law's house?" Now Minnie understood what is the meaning of father-in-law. She flushed up at the question and kept standing before him with her face down. She was standing with her face turned down because she had forgotten her train. After she had gone, Rema heaved a deep sigh. The idea had suddenly come to him that his daughter too must have grown during all those years. He would have to make friends with her anew. And besides, what might not have happened to her in these 8 years? Now as Minnie left the room, as Minnie went back, The Kabulwala heaved a deep sigh. He understood that his daughter too must have grown big now, because the time when he was bringing nuts, his daughter was also small like Minnie. But now Minnie had grown so much big, then it must that his daughter also had grown big. And what not have happened in these many years? In these 8 years, how many years? 8 years Kabulwala was in the jail. So what might not happen in these 8 years? Like this thing, he was thinking of his daughter. "I took out a banknote and gave it to him. Go back to your own daughter, Rehman, in your own country. I said, may the happiness of your meeting bring good fortune to my child." Now when Rehman was thinking about his daughter, Minnie's father took out a banknote and he gave it to Rehman and he said, "Go to your country, go back to your daughter. Rehman, go back to your daughter in your own country and may the happiness of your meeting bring good fortune to my child." And he said that, "Today's your meeting with my child may bring happiness in her life." The marriage pipe sounded. To me, their music sounded all the sweeter to think that in a distant land, a long lost father would meet again his only child. Now see, the marriage pipe sounded. Okay, the marriage pipe sounded. Music was there of the marriage. And for Minnie's father, what was more sweeter than this music? Music of marriage pipe? What was more sweeter than to think that a distant land, a long lost father would meet his only child? Means Rema would meet his daughter, and that was more sweeter for Minnie's father than the marriage pipe it was sounding. So dear students, here our lesson gets over. I hope you understood this very nice story of friendship between Minnie and the Kabulwala. The Kabulwala did not forget Minnie till the end, and he always was thinking Minnie as his daughter, and he was bringing things for her. So dear students, I hope you understood this story. You complete all the exercises in your book and in notebook. In our next video, we will start the exercises.